Hello, good morning to all of you. Today, I would like to study some of the methods of solid waste management. There are various solid waste management methods are there. Few of them are sanitary landfill, incineration methods, composting, etc. First of all, we would like to understand sanitary landfill method. This is the most popularly adopted waste disposal method. In this method, garbage is spread out in thin layer in a big pit. The big pit is made and the bottom of the pit is covered by a layer. The property of the layer is such that it is impervious one. Impervious means it is not allowing any of the chemicals to move from inside the pit to the outside the pit towards the bottom side. Okay. So this is what the meaning of the impervious. So now, and this liner, above that liner, you know, sand is covered, and thereafter, layer by layer, garbage is spread in the form of the thin layer, and then it is garbage is pressed, and once again there will be the garbage is added. Likewise, compressing and placing over the garbage over it, layer by layer is made. And then when the complete entire pit, the big pit is going to be filled completely, then the surface of that pit is covered by the clay or as well as sand, and it will be gravel to prevent the seepage of water into the pit. You can just have the look at the schematic diagram of that landfill. This is a big pit here. This is you know, the side wall. This is the bottom wall, and this is once again the side wall. All these are impervious liners. Won't allow any, you know, the toxic material to move from inside to the outside. So now, this is covered by the bottom layer is covered by the sand, and you know, layer by layer garbage is you know, added here, and then when the complete pit is covered by the garbage, the surface of that is, you know, covered by the clay as well as sand. It will be totally capped, and in such a way it is going to be capped, no water molecule can get inside this. Now there will be an arrangement of a pipe from bottom of this pit towards the top to escape, to make feasible the formation of the gas to go away. Any gas formed within the pit can easily escape to the outside. In such a way, the arrangement is made. And due to anaerobic condition and due to the compression at high pressure, slowly the degraded, degraded waste is going to be converted into, you know, the semi-solid material, and slowly, you know, some leachants are going to be present here at the bottom in the form of the liquid, and then gaseous product is collected from this, and that gaseous product is having the property of property similar to the fuel. It can be used to make combustion, and then, you know, the leachant from the waste can be collected at the tank, separate tank. It is, with the help of, borehole technique. Okay, so a pipe is inserted and air is pushed from outside to the inside, and that air compressed at the inside will push all the liquid upside, and then leachant will be collected here. Likewise, and such say pits are made very near to the say this pit. Okay, so the entire land is made use for the dumping of the waste only, and nearby to this landfills there will be generally a borewell is made in order to understand whether from the landfills any leakages are there. Okay, if there are any leakages, the toxic chemicals are going to be mixed with the soil in turn with the groundwater, and then as and when groundwater is taken out with the help of the borewell, that can be subjected to chemical analysis to understand the nature of the intoxication associated with the water, and hence further action can be taken to improvise the landfill. Incineration is one of the methods where the burning of the entire solid waste will be conducted to turn the entire waste into ashes. So this is a very popular method adopted by municipalities as well as some of the institutions, and in this method the waste, once it is going to be done, it is going to be reduced for about 20 to 30% of the original volume. This is one of the highlighting thing associated with this. Usually the biomedical waste are subjected to incineration as well as pyrolysis also. There are various solid waste management methods are there. Few of them are sanitary landfill, incineration methods, composting, etc. First of all, we would like to understand sanitary landfill method. This is the most popularly adopted waste disposal method. In this method, garbage is spread out in thin layer in a big pit. The big pit is made, and the bottom of the pit is covered by a layer. The property of the layer is such that it is impervious one. Impervious means it is not allowing any of the chemicals to move from inside the pit to the outside of the pit towards the bottom side. Okay, so this is what the meaning of the impervious. So now, and this liner, above that liner, sand is covered, and thereafter layer by layer garbage is spread in the form of the thin layer, and then it is garbage is pressed, and once again there will be the garbage is added. Likewise, compressing and placing over the garbage over it layer by layer is made. And any further details, if you would like to go make understand, okay, so you can just ponder over or look over the various slides shared in the share.net. So the website address is here. So various slides are available there to understand the same concept in a much more better way. Composting is one of the good old method adopted in India, particularly in our villages also. Biodegradable waste are only used here for the composting purposes, and these biodegradable waste are composted, in the options of the air, okay, so they are kept and then they will be slowly transformed into manure, and this manure is used for agricultural process agricultural purpose to get the good yield of the crop. Okay, so pyrolysis is once again the burning of the waste only. Here this method involves the solid waste chemically decomposed by heat in the absence of the oxygen. The pressure adopted in this particular process is high, temperature is also high, around 400 degrees centigrade to 450 degrees centigrade temperature is used here, and in this high temperature the solid waste is converted into solid residue as well as gas, and this significantly reduces the volume, and particularly biomedical waste is going to be treated treated by means of pyrolysis. I will take one example to make you understand better. Biomedical waste essentially many of the time consists of very very toxic viruses as well as bacteria. First of the patient or operated people, therefore those are very infectious substances, and the clinical laboratories also contributing a lot, and these at high temperature and pressure when they are subjected to burning process, they will be undergoing complete decomposition to kill all the viruses and bacteria, and lastly this hydrocarbons are also going to be converted into carbon dioxide gases as well as moisture, and metals if at all they are associated with the biomedical waste, for example use and throw syringe, it will be having needle as a waste, usually it will be having a syringe, so that will be after usage it will be treated as a biomedical waste. When it is subjected to pyrolysis, metal will be remaining as it is, needle will be remaining as it is, and that will be subjected to recycling process. Likewise various biomedical devices, metallical objects associated with them, they will be sent to recycling process. Okay, so in this way various methods are there, and some of the methods are also there, recycling methods means that is a method which can be wisely chosen for a particular subject, for a particular waste. What I mean to tell you is biomedical waste cannot be recycled, but whereas plastic materials which were used as a home utensils can be after the usage can be broken into smaller pieces and they can be reused, and recycling process can be done for the glasses. Okay, likewise and e-waste, it is nothing but the name itself, as I told, it is adopted to the products which are which have become waste after the usage, particularly for mobiles, electronic products, once they have been used, when they become unusable form, then they are called as e-waste. And the recycling can also be done. Okay, so from the unused say object, one can disassemble all the unused say object, and whatever the say parts, they can be reused for making another device. Okay, that can be taken out, and that is called as the recycling process or reused process. And in this way, okay, recycling and reusing is one of the solid waste method. It is going to be considered as. There are so many methods out there, and you have understood, I think, few of them. Okay, thank you for listening to patience. Patiencefully.